us. And we have a new doctor, so we have fake doctors. And we have a new preacher, so also we have fake preachers, who in many cases are more eloquent, more gifted than politicians and actors and actresses in preaching and telling you what you want to hear.
Amen.
And sometimes I see heavens will fall down. They provide answers to every human need, and you get your feet swept away.
Hallelujah.
I won't come to Gospel Lord Church again. I'm going to change the text. I'm going to this. You are telling lies. You are just deceiving yourself. You come back again. But Christ knows who are his, serving him in the spirit and in truth.
Amen.
I must admit here that God can use anybody he wills to preach. Even Satan agents do glorify God. The Lord was asked by one of his disciples if they should stop and prevent someone who was not following them, but preaching and working miracles with the name of Jesus. In Luke 9:49-50, Master, said John, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he is not one of us. And the master said, do not stop him. Jesus said, for whoever is not against you is for you.
Amen.
Amen. Jesus knew at the end times, many false preachers and teachers will arise and perform miracles and do wonders. And hence he warned them, those who are his, in many words and on many occasions. And this brings us again this morning to our today's sermon. Can we all take our Bible and open to John 6:40-71? John 6:40-71. Are we all there? John 6:40-71. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who beholds the Son and believes in him will have eternal life. And I myself will raise him up on the last day. Therefore, the Jews grumbling about him, because he said, I am the bread that came down out of heaven. They were saying, is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How does he now say, I have come down out of heaven? And Jesus answered and said to them, do not grumble among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. And I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught of God. Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. And this is the bread which comes down out of heaven, so that one may eat it and not die.
Amen.
I am the living bread that came down out of heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread also which I will give for the life of the world is my flesh.
Amen.
Then the Jews began to argue with one another, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in yourselves. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he who is me, he also will live because of me. And this is the bread which came down out of heaven. Not as the fathers ate and died. He who eats this bread will live forever. These things he said in the synagogue as he taught in Capernaum. Therefore, many of the disciples, when they heard this, said, this is a difficult statement. Who can listen to it? But Jesus, conscious that his disciples grumbled at this, said to them, does this cause you also to stumble? What then if you see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and are life. But there are some of you who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the beginning who they were who did not believe and who it was that would betray him. And he was saying, for this reason, I have said to you that no one can come to me unless it has been granted him from the Father. As a result of this, many of his followers and disciples withdrew, and we are not working with him anymore. So Jesus said to the 12, you do not want to go away also, do you? Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? You are the ones of eternal life. We have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God. Amen. Jesus answered them, did I myself not choose you, the 12? And yet one of you is a devil. Now him and Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot. For he, one of the 12, was going to betray him. And now you may be wondering, if Jesus did know, those who are false teachers and false preachers, you may be asking why did he still allow them to prosper and excel in their ungodly ministration? The same question disciples ask him in the parables of the weeds. They should go and uproot all the weeds from the field. And what was his answer? For the benefit of those of us who don't yet know much about the Bible, let us open our Bible to Matthew 13. Matthew 13, 24 to 29. Matthew 13, 24 to 29. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted up and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from? And the master said, an enemy did this, he replied. The servant asked him, do you want us to go and pull them up? No, he answered. Because you are pulling the weeds, you may also uproot the weeds with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the wheat and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn. Some of us have heard this parable about how the kingdom of heaven is like, but do we really understand? Or bother to find out the meaning of this parable? This parable.